Till now we have seen that in bomb calorimeter, whatever the reaction was going on, it is carried out at constant volume. Okay, even for reactions involving gases, there is no work done as delta V is equal to 0. P delta V is nothing but work done, ma, in which delta V is equal to 0 means P delta V is also 0, then work done is equal to 0. Temperature change of the calorimeter produced by the complete reaction is then converted to QV. What is the temperature change? T2 minus T1 is there, na? The change in temperature is completely converted to QV, heat energy. QV is equal to C into delta D. QV is equal to CV into delta T. By knowing that CV value and delta T, we can find the QV by using the known heat capacity. That's why only it is very important for us to know heat capacity. Directly we cannot find heat energy, whatever it is required or involved in the reaction, but by change in temperature, by the observation of change in temperature by keeping the thermometer, we can estimate by using this formula. QV is equal to CV into delta T. So by using this full bomb calorimeter, in this way we are going to find the change in internal energy of the system. Is it okay, ma? So whatever the system we are going to find change in internal energy, that one we are going to take it as sample. I hope you are clear, ma. Next. Let us see next heading. Delta H measurements. What is this delta H? Change in heat energy at constant pressure. What is that? Change in heat energy at constant pressure. Okay, now let us see that one, ma. What is meant by delta H, ma? Change in heat energy at constant pressure. See, measurement of heat change at constant pressure, generally under atmospheric pressure, can be done in a calorimeter shown in figure 6.8. I will show the diagram. We know that delta H is equal to QP at constant pressure, and therefore heat absorbed or evolved at constant pressure is also called the heat of reaction or enthalpy of reaction. Is it okay, ma? Delta H R. In an exothermic reaction, heat is evolved and system loses heat to the surroundings. Therefore, QP will be negative and delta H will also be negative. Similarly, in an endothermic reaction, heat is absorbed, QP is positive and delta H will be also positive. Why it is positive and why it is negative, clearly we will understand. I will take examples and I will say for you, ma. I will explain the reason. Before that, delta H values can be found by using this equipment. Calorimeter for measuring heat changes at constant pressure. Okay. This is formed polystyrene cup. Inside we have taken reaction mixture. In the thermometer we have kept. Okay. That reaction mixture will undergo reaction and it will release heat energy. Because of that heat energy, temperature of this thermometer will be increased. By observing the change in thermometer reading, delta T, and the formula QP is equal to CP into delta T. Delta T value is known. Okay. By knowing the CP value, heat capacity at constant pressure of this reaction mixture, we will come to know what about this QP. Okay. This is the equipment, same like previous one only, ma. Here pressure is constant, in previous one volume is constant. That is only difference. Is it okay? Same like previous experiment only. This one also will be explained. By changing thermometer reading only, we will understand. Is it okay? This is about delta H measurements and delta U measurements. Previously we have seen delta U measurement, now it is delta H measurement. I hope you are clear, my everyone. Okay, now let us see what about the enthalpy change. Next, our next concept is enthalpy change is nothing but delta H for reactions we are considering now. Here onwards, this term, this we can give one side heading, that is thermochemistry. In thermodynamics, regarding heat energies of reactions, we are going to study from here onwards. Okay, main part, whatever the definition, Cp, Cv, work done, okay, work done at constant pressure, work done at constant volume, all are completed till now. Okay, now whatever the heat energy changes in reactions, we are going to study from here. That's why from here the concept we can tell it as thermochemistry. Okay, how we are going to study this one? Let us see. Our side heading is enthalpy change, delta H of reaction, reaction enthalpy. Okay, see here now. Enthalpy change of reaction or reaction of enthalpy reaction, enthalpy of reaction or reaction enthalpy. Here heading itself it is denoted that enthalpy change, we are going to represent that one as delta H R. Okay ma, now let us consider one reaction. AA plus BB gives rise to AB. AA plus BB gives rise to AB. This is the reaction I considered. Okay, for this reaction how we are going to calculate the enthalpy change? Okay, first let us consider AA molecules and BB molecules. To undergo any reaction, old bonds must be broken and new bonds must be formed. Then only the reaction will be done, otherwise the reaction will not be happened. If old bonds are not broken easily, the reaction cannot be happened easily. Is it okay, ma? Now between A and A the bond is there. The amount of energy required to break the bond between A and A is called heat energy of A2, which is also called bond energy of A2. The amount of energy required to break the bond between BB is heat energy of B2. Okay, ma? Here, whatever we are giving energy, that energy is absorbed by A2 and B2. Whatever the energy we are giving, that energy is absorbed by A2 and B2. So this side, this total amount of energy, HA2 plus HB2 is called H reactants. Substances which are undergoing reaction are called reactants. This total energy required for breaking the bonds of the reactants is called H reactants. Is it okay, ma? Next, coming to right side, products are going to be formed by the reaction between A and B. A bond is going to be formed. At the time of formation of bond, energy is going to be released. At the time of formation of bond, energy is going to be released. Is it okay? Observe carefully. At the time of formation of any bond or any attraction, energy will be released. The remaining amount of energy for AB is called heat energy of AB. The remaining amount of energy of AB is called heat energy of AB, which is called heat energy of products. Okay, see, some amount of energy is lost to the surroundings. Then remaining amount of energy for AB. Suppose, let us think that 10 joules of energy must be present. In that, 5 joules of energy is released. Then remaining amount of energy for AB is 5 joules. That is heat energy of products. Okay, remaining amount of energy is heat energy of products. This is heat energy of, that is enthalpy of reactants. This is enthalpy of products. Now, this side reactants energy is observed. Okay. Heat energy of products remained this side. That means enthalpy of products. Now, what is meant by delta H? Delta H is change in heat enthalpy of reaction. What is that? Change in enthalpy of reaction is equal to delta HR. That one I told here. Delta RHR here. Okay. Delta RH is equal to heat energy of products minus heat energy of reactants. Delta RH is equal to heat energy of products minus heat energy of reactants. Are you able to understand, ma? Delta HR is nothing but delta H of reaction. Change in enthalpy of reaction is equal to enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. In the above explanation, enthalpy of products is less than enthalpy of reactants, because on product side energy is released, na? So the remaining amount of energy is less than definitely heat energy of reactants. When enthalpy of products is less than enthalpy of reactants, delta H R is equal to negative. Delta RH is equal to negative. This is the net reaction energy, enthalpy. Change in enthalpy of reaction is equal to negative. In that case, energy is released. So that is called exothermic reaction. In case of exothermic reaction, delta H is equal to negative. Okay, next. If the reaction is happened by heat energy of products greater than heat energy of reactants, means energy is absorbed on product side. Heat energy of products is greater than heat energy of reactants. That means enthalpy of products is greater than enthalpy of reactants. Then delta RH is equal to products greater than reactants means positive value. You will get positive. That is called endothermic. Okay, ma? That's why we will write for exothermic delta H is equal to negative, but not actually energy negative, ma. Okay, negative is representing energy is released, positive representing energy is absorbed. Negative is representing energy is released, positive is representing energy is absorbed. Okay, that's why previously I told, na, how we can see this one. See, here, similarly in an endothermic reaction, see, Q QP will be negative and delta HR will also be negative. Similarly, in an endothermic reaction, heat is observed. QP is positive and delta H will also be positive. So for every endothermic reaction, delta H is positive. For every exothermic reaction, delta H is negative. That is only they gave here. Okay, now they are representing some sigma values, all these things. No? Sigma is nothing but sum of heat energies of products. Suppose sometimes more than one product also might be there. So enthalpy of total products is nothing but sigma. Addition of enthalpy of products. This is sigma reactants, meaning sigma is nothing but sum of enthalpy of reactants. Suppose here observe the reaction CH4 plus 2O2 gives rise to CO2 plus 2H2O. CH4 plus 2O2 gives rise to CO2 plus 2H2O. For this reaction, these are the reactants, these are the products. Heat energy of CH4, first we are going to see products. See, heat energy of CO2 plus 2 into heat energy of water. M is nothing but mole. Here we are considering with moles only, na? Okay. Heat energy per mole of H2O into 2. Because here 2 coefficient is there, na? That's why into 2. Plus heat energy of CO2. These two sum is nothing but sigma of heat energy of products. Next, minus this minus here. HM, meaning enthalpy of 1 mole of CH4. But 2 is not there or any other coefficient is not there. So, we will not write any coefficient. If you have coefficient, then only you will write 2 here. Okay. Gas plus 2 is there here. 2 into enthalpy of mole of O2. These are reactants. These are products. Products minus reactants energy is equal to delta H. Sigma is representing sum. Where HM is the molar enthalpy, meaning enthalpy of 1 mole of the substance is called molar enthalpy. Generally, we cannot consider enthalpy for 1 molecule or 2 molecule like that. For 1 mole only, we will consider 1 or 2 moles, 3 moles like that. That's why mole concept is also very important. Enthalpy change is a very useful quantity. Knowledge of this quantity is required when one needs to plan the heating or cooling required to maintain an industrial chemical reaction at constant temperature. It is also required to calculate temperature dependence of equilibrium constant. Okay, this is about enthalpy change of a reaction, which is called reaction enthalpy. Okay, this is general representation. From here onwards, we are going to study standard enthalpy of reaction, enthalpy changes during phase transformations, like that various types are there, enthalpy of neutralization, standard enthalpy of formation, enthalpy of neutralization, Hessler, thermochemical equation, like that all definitions we are going to see from now onwards which are related to enthalpy only. Enthalpy of atomization, bond enthalpy, like that, these are all terms related to standard enthalpy of combustion, like that, various definitions of related to various reactions we have. My day-to-day life, we are undergoing so many different types of reactions. Okay, for all those reactions, enthalpy is represented. That is why we are going to see all these definitions. Enthalpy of combustion, enthalpy of neutralization, enthalpy of atomization, okay, lattice enthalpy, everything clearly we are going to see, and Hessler, all these things. Okay, by that maximum we came to end of the chapter and we are going to be remained with spontaneity. Correctly within two classes we can complete this chapter. after completion of this enthalpy definitions, ma, enthalpy definitions and spontaneity, all these are required with two more classes. By the two more classes, we will complete this chapter. Okay, I hope you are understanding every concept. Okay, everything is clear for you. Any sort of doubts you have, immediately you can contact me, already I told. Okay, don't hesitate to ask the doubts. I hope you are clear about today's class. Okay, ma. In today's class, we have seen how we can calculate the delta H values by using that equipment. How we can calculate the delta H value. And next, what about the enthalpy change of reaction we have seen in today's class. Next class onwards, we will start what about the enthalpies of various reactions. Okay, and we will go through the chapter like that. This is about today's class, ma. I hope you are clear. Thank you all. Have a nice day.